Welcome dear students, how are you all? I hope you all will be fine. So now let us begin with a new academic year. Myself, Miss Urvi. This year I am going to teach you science. So we are going to use this environmental studies part 1 textbook. Yes, in this book we will have two subjects, that will be science and geography. So whenever we are teaching the lessons from this textbook, we will tell whether to consider it in science or geography. So now I am going to teach you the first lesson, our earth and our solar system. So that lesson we are going to consider it science. Okay, so let us begin with the first lesson of science. Very interesting lesson, that is our earth and our solar system. So now the first lesson, our earth and our solar system. Children, do you like to do sky watch? Of course some of you may be interested in that. Mostly we like to watch the sky at the night time. What do you see and which color do you see in the sky at that time? Yes, we see black color sky, which is consisting many tiny twinkling stars in it. Have you ever watched the size of the stars? Some stars are prominent, means they are very famous. Okay, while some are tiny and faint. We see many of them twinkle, but some of them do not twinkle. Are these stars close to us? No, they are very far away from us. Now we will just talk about the sun and the moon. Are they close to us? They are comparatively close to us. So we are visible with their round shape. All the stars, sun, moon, planets are called as heavenly bodies. Heavenly bodies means the bodies which are present in sky are called as heavenly bodies. So are this sky, are this star, sun, moon present in sky? And are they far away from us? So as they are far away and as they are located in sky, they are called as heavenly bodies. Now our first heavenly body, that is star. The heavenly bodies that twinkle are called stars. Stars have their own light. Now for example, if we'll consider earth and star, are these both of them heavenly bodies? Yes, but stars are giving their own light. Okay, earth is not giving its own light, so earth is called something else. Those who twinkle, those who give light are called as star. Now we will see who is the star. So sun is one of the star which is very close to us compared to other stars. So can you see the size of sun big? Yes, it is. Sun is a star which is closer to us than other stars and it appears very big. Now where are these stars during the daytime? Children, these stars are there in the sky, but because of the light of the sun, bright light. Okay, how is the light? Bright light of the sun, the stars are not visible to us during the daytime. But as soon as the sun sets, once the light becomes dim, we are able to see the stars. So during day also we are having the stars present in the sky, but they are not visible because of the bright light. So sun is our a big star It appears very big and brilliant means very bright. So now we'll see the second concept, that is planets. The heavenly bodies that do not twinkle are called planets. Do not twinkle means they don't give out the light. Then from where do they get light? They get light from stars. Okay. Now, one more thing about planets, that is, planets are always revolving around star. And which is that star? Sun. Okay. So planets revolve around sun. Okay. What did we learn? Planets do not have their own light. So they get light from the star and they always revolve around the star. Now the next third point we are going to see, that is the solar system. The planets and the sun together are called as solar system. The solar system. The sun and the planets that revolve around it are together called as solar system. There are seven planets, that are Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. So our Earth is also one of the planet, and it gets light from the sun. It moves around the sun, and that movement of moving around the sun is called as revolution of the Earth. Every planet in the solar system revolves around the sun in a specific path. Okay, that particular path is called as a planet's orbit. Besides planet, there are also different heavenly bodies present in the solar system. So here you can see these white lines. Yes, these white lines are the orbit. So you can see here we are having sun, the brightest star. Okay, close to the sun we are having Mercury, Venus, Earth. Suppose we are seeing now Jupiter. Can you see these white lines? So this is the orbit, means Jupiter is going to move only along its path. This is path of Jupiter. So this is called as Jupiter's orbit. Okay, so it will, whenever it has to move, whenever it is moving around the sun, it will move in this particular orbit. So now we have learned the two things, that is about the stars and the planets. The heavenly bodies that twinkle are called stars, correct, and the heavenly bodies that do not twinkle are called planets. And one more thing, children, planets revolve around star. Okay, now we'll see other heavenly bodies in solar system. The first one is satellite. So these are also heavenly bodies, but these heavenly bodies revolve around planets. Okay, and they are called as satellites. Now they also don't have their own light like our planets. Okay, satellites also do not have their own light. So from whom do they get light? They also get light from the sun. Okay, and we can see them only because of the sun's light. Okay, so which is our satellite? Moon. Okay, moon is the satellite of the Earth. So do you see it at the night time? Yes. So moon is satellite of the Earth because moon is revolving around the Earth. Okay, now many of the planets are having, most of the planets are having their own satellites, and these planets also revolve around the sun along with their satellites. Okay, so here can you see the Earth? Can you see your Earth's orbit? Yes. So small dot is present over here, that is moon. Okay, you can see clearly in your own textbook also. So that, see here, this is Earth and this is moon. So moon is satellite of this earth. So moon is revolving around earth and earth is revolving around sun. Means indirectly moon also revolves around the sun. They don't, both of them do not have light. So they get it from sun. So this is, moon is called as satellite. Why? Because it is revolving around planet, and these are planets which are revolving around stars. Are you clear about it? So now other heavenly body, that is dwarf planets. So these are also heavenly bodies which revolve around the sun, but they are smaller heavenly bodies, very small. Compared to other planets, these are very small. Smaller heavenly bodies that revolve around the sun are called as a dwarf planets. So one of the dwarf planet is Pluto. They also move. Now how planets are revolving around the sun, like this is dwarf planets also revolve around the sun, and they also have their own orbit. So now between Mars and Jupiter, okay, this is orbit of Mars and this is orbit of Jupiter. Now between these two orbits, can you see a band of heavenly bodies? See this band of numerous small heavenly heavenly body between Mars and Jupiter is called as asteroids. This asteroid also revolve around the sun. Now compared to the sun, other heavenly bodies, that is planets, dwarf planets, asteroids, okay, they are very very small. Even satellites are also very small compared to the sun. But moon appears close to the earth. Can you see here? Moon is very close to the earth, so we can see it in a big size. But actually moon is also smaller than the sun. Okay, so all other heavenly bodies are smaller than the sun, and all these stars, planets, satellites, asteroids, dwarf planets together form a solar system. So they all are the part of solar system. The next point, that is gravity. The force of attraction towards itself is called as gravity. Now in the previous diagram we have seen all the planets are moving in its own orbit. Yes, it is only because of the force of gravity. All these heavenly bodies exert a force of attraction towards one another, so they are able to stand steady at their own place, and that force is called as a force of gravity. So whenever you throw a ball up high into the sky, it comes down. Yes, even when a fruit is ready, where does it fall? It falls on the ground. That is also a force of gravity. Okay, so because of this force of gravity, all the things on the earth remain on it. Most of the time you have seen that many people are more curious about heavenly bodies. They want to know about them, study about them, even they want to reach them. So to reach them, we can send some objects into the space. But by sending, we need more power against the force of gravity. So for that purpose, we have to use rocket technology or space launch technology. So now we have heard a new word, that is space. So what is space? The emptiness between and beyond the stars and planets is called space. Have you seen this kind of Diwali firecracker? So these firecrackers is packed with explosive substance, and when this explosive substance burns, then it produces lot of energy, and because of that energy this firecracker is pushed in a certain direction at a greater speed. Very powerful rockets are sent in space. They are waging thousands of tons, and to send these rockets into the space we require huge quantity of fuel. Here this huge quantity of fuel is burned, and then these rockets are sent to into the space. Now in 20th century very few countries of the world have developed space technology and are sending hundreds of spacecrafts. Our country is well known for the development of its space launch technology. Now some of these spacecraft remain in space. Some of them go and settle in and are kept in or on some planets and satellites. Some are brought back to the Earth. Even some of the scientists travel through this spacecraft, and these scientists are called as astronauts. So do you know who is the first Indian astronaut? Yes, very good. Rakesh Sharma is the first Indian astronaut. He was sent in the space in 1984. He had spent 8 days on a space station, and his mission was for a joint mission of the ISRO and the Soviet Intercosmos. So when he reached there and when he looked down from the space, he said, "Sare jahan se acha." Why did he say that? Because our India is more beautiful country. Do you know India's space mission? On 22nd October 2008, ISRO launched spacecraft to the moon, and this mission is called Chandrayaan 1. And another Indian space mission was launched on 5th November 2013. It is known as MOM or Mars Orbit Mission, and also known as Mangalyaan. It got established on 24th September 2014 in orbit around the planet Mars. Both these missions are unmanned, that is, there were no people on board. The objective of this mission was deeper study of Moon and Mars. And the last point, that is man-made satellites. So the satellites made by man are called as man-made satellite. Now what is the use of this man-made satellite? To collect information for agriculture, about environment, weather forecasting means changes in weather, making maps, and to search water and minerals on the earth, we can make use of man-made satellites. Also we can use for telecommunication, means for long way communication using telephones, long distance communication. Okay, and these satellites are put around the Earth's orbit, and they can remain in that orbit for many years. So here the lesson is over. So always remember, till today scientists have never found any other planet who has life on it. Only our Earth is having a life on it. So our Earth is an invaluable planet. Stop degradation of it. And if there is degradation of its environment, it will be a threat to the existence of life
itself.
Now children, you have to read the whole lesson with understanding, and then we are going to write answer to the questions which are tick marked over here. So you will write the question and along with the answer in your CW. So the first question what you are going to write, that is, who am I? Read the question, write it down and write the answer. Next question is, answer the following. Write the question and write answer to this two questions in the rough books, whatever CWs you all are using, no? In that you can write this question. So first you write the lesson name, write the date, and then write question 1, who am I, and question 2, answer the following.